Hi guys, it's Diana. Welcome to my channel. You know, it's kind of a dark and gloomy day here, so I've decided to make some candles and light up my day. As you can see, I have everything I need. I picked up this little kit from Joann Fabric. You know, I love me some Joann Fabric. It's a 6-piece set and it has all of the ingredients that you need with the exception of wick stickums. I like to use a sticker on the bottom of my wick to stick it to the base of the candle container. So I have those on hand. You can pick those up off of Amazon. I think it was like 10 bucks. You can pick up this kit for a total of $19.33 all in by the time I paid for shipping and tax. Here you have some of the tricks of the trade, some of the tools of the trade. I've also spread out a length of, these are just grocery sacks because I don't want to mess up my counter. Wax sticks to everything and it is kind of a pain in the head to get off. Make sure you've covered your workspace with something to protect it. Let's go for it. You're going to fill your bottom of your broiler up with just a couple inches of water. I'm letting my water heat. I want it to a very low boil, and then I will put my wax on. I'm just gonna wrap my wick around my pencil here, and then take a length of tape. Make sure it's as centered as you can, and put a little tape. And then that way it won't come unwound while you're pouring. What we're looking for is we're just trying to get all of it to melt. And then I'm gonna add my pigment. All right, I'll add a little bit of yellow. Ah, look at that green. My high school art teacher would be very proud. Now, I like that green. You may not, that's okay. We don't all have to agree with each other. Okay, now when scenting with essential oils, the mixture has to be at the right temperature. You don't want it to be too hot or they'll evaporate. Right now it is way too hot. So we're actually gonna take it off the burner. I'll let it cool down. It'll probably do so rather rapidly. So we're just gonna stand here and watch it. I know that sounds really boring, so I will spare you. So what we're gonna do is just add this and stir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and stir. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and stir. All right, now we're ready to pour. Now what I've done is, I also like to secure my wick holder, so I tape a little bit to the side of my jar. And then we're just gonna pour, guys. Now, we'll let it sit like this for, you know, I like to let them sit for a full day, honestly, before I do anything else to them, just to make sure they're good and cured.